the genetic information. So in a sense, these are the three different types of DNA conformation. This is the BDNA, which is the most, which is the common one, and which is much more aligned, you can say here. But in case of ADNA, we can see this is a short fat. So this is short fat version of the BDNA. Okay, and in case of here is a ZDNA, which is long and thin version of the BDNA. That's how you can memorize all these things. Now here are the top view of this DNA, the molecular view. You can see in all these cases, this is a very different kind of drawings. This is the structure of BDNA. This is the structure of ZDNA. This is the structure of ADNA. Remember one thing, these blue things are the bases. And here are the sugar and the phosphates are, these yellows are the phosphate. These are the sugars and the blue are the bases. So in this picture, what we are looking in ADNA, there are congestion of to make the arrangement of this bases because of their bulkier formation, because of their less area or less pitch which is provided in case of ADNA. But in case of ZDNA, we can see it is aligned in various different layers to maintain the structure. But in BDNA, it is much more aligned, it is much more stacked with the help of stacking interaction, which is nothing but the hydrophobic interaction between bases and the van der Waals interactions to help the structure in a very good mannered way. So this is the parameters of polynucleotide helix. In case of ADNA, it is right-handed, BDNA is also right-handed, ZDNA is left-handed. So this is the odd in there. In B form, this is a 10 residue, A form 11, and Z form 12. Which is actually made up with 6 dimers. That's another important part of it. So if you look at the rotational per residue, in case of BDNA, found 36 degree to make a spiral. Again, all these DNA are different spirals. So in case of ADNA, this is slightly slower than 33 degree. But in case of Z form, it is minus 60 degree per dimer. That's why that and another is the minus 30 degree per dimer. That gives us the idea about the zigzag nature of this Z form of the DNA. Okay, the rise in case of B form is and the pitch of the BDNA is 3.4 nanometer. It contains 10 residues, so the rise is 0.34 nanometer. In case of ADNA, the pitch is 2.8. In case of ZDNA, the pitch is higher, so the ZDNA is longer, but it is thinner. Okay, so these are the basic part or basic conception about their structure. So one thing you should remember, ADNA, BDNA is the common one. Whatever we have studied, most of the part is regarding the BDNA. ADNA is a thinner and longer version of BDNA, and the ZDNA is ADNA is the shorter. Sorry, it's a horrible mistake. ADNA is the shorter and the fat version of the BDNA, and ZDNA is the longer and thinner version of BDNA. If you memorize this, you'll never forget the structure. All about the conception, about the arrangement. So in this lecture, we have discussed about the different forms of DNAs. In first case, we discussed about the stacking interaction, the sugar puckering, and why the sugar puckerings are important, and how the sugar puckering and stacking interaction helps to help the structure of the DNA together. What are the different forms of DNAs? That is A form, B form, and Z form. What these different forms suggests us, and why the A and B and Z forms are stabilized, and what are the conditions of making the non-canonical structures like A form and Z form of the DNA. Okay, that's all about this lecture, and I hope that's going to help you. Thank you.